Well, lawmakers today delayed action on two of the biggest bills at the 2019 legislature, Medicaid expansion and the so-called Save Colstrip bill. And those delays probably aren't a coincidence. As MTN's chief political reporter Mike Dennison reports, the bills are becoming part of final negotiations on how to wrap up the session.
The bill to continue Medicaid expansion had been scheduled for a debate and vote on the Senate floor Wednesday, one of its final steps before heading to the governor's desk. But as the floor session began, GOP leaders announced that the bill had been pulled and the debate rescheduled for Thursday. In the House, a committee also had planned to vote Wednesday afternoon on the Colstrip bill, but that action has been delayed until Friday. GOP leaders and lawmakers cited many reasons for delaying the Medicaid vote, such as waiting for more amendments or for a new summary of the bill's finances. But Republican Senator Duane Ankeny of Colstrip confirmed to reporters that another reason is concern over whether Governor Bullock, a Democrat, will accept the Colstrip bill, which has been strongly criticized by many Democrats. The Colstrip measure, Senate Bill 331, is meant to encourage Northwestern Energy to buy more of the Colstrip 4 power plant and prolong the plant's life. It does so by guaranteeing that Northwestern can collect up to $75 million from ratepayers over the next 10 years for capital expense at the plant. MTN News asked Bullock Wednesday whether he could support the bill in its current form.
I would say that continue to have skepticism that 331 in its current form is really a good deal for Montana.
But Ankeny told MTN News that he spoke with the governor's office earlier Wednesday and amendments to 331 may be in the works to make it more acceptable to the governor. Other Republican senators, however, said they still expect the Medicaid vote to be close on Thursday. Some Republicans whose votes are needed to pass it are unhappy about a variety of issues still unresolved at the session. Bullock, of course, is a big supporter of Medicaid expansion and has made its passage a top priority. The $700 million a year program provides health coverage to 95,000 low-income Montanans. So, welcome to the last 2 weeks of the session. When tempers get short, votes get close, and deals get made. Or not. But whatever happens, I think we'll be talking about both of these bills until the bitter end. At the Capitol, Mike Dennison, MTN News.
Lawmakers also need to pass a state budget and wrap up some other major items as well before the final scheduled day of May 1st.